Dental caries is a microbial disease of the calcified tissues of the tooth, characterized by demineralization of the inorganic portion and dissolution of the organic portion of the tooth. It is a dynamic process where the balance between mineralization and demineralization tilts in favor of demineralization. Now, this balance depends on several factors like structure of tooth, dental plaque, saliva, microorganisms, diet consumed, and the frequency of food consumption. A significant factor influencing the formation of dental caries is dental plaque. Dental plaque is a yellowish-white deposit or biofilm that forms on the teeth and other hard structures in the oral cavity. It comprises predominantly of bacterial communities in a matrix of exfoliated epithelial cells, bacterial and salivary proteins. In addition to proteins, the matrix may also harbor carbohydrates like glucans, fructans, and other polysaccharides synthesized by bacteria, lipid material, and inorganic constituents like calcium and phosphate. The dental plaque cannot be removed by physiologic tongue movements, salivary flow, or even when flushed with water. However, it could be removed on toothbrushing. Dental plaque formation starts with the acquired pellicle formation. Now, acquired pellicle is a coating made of salivary glycoproteins on the surface of the tooth, which immediately forms in a matter of seconds after toothbrushing. This coating of salivary pellicle helps in adherence of bacteria to the tooth via receptors that are recognized by bacterial molecules called adhesins. Now, these initial bacteria are called primary colonizers in the dental plaque. Extracellular polysaccharides secreted by bacteria help in adhesion of more bacteria on the existing bacteria in the plaque. Secondary colonizers kick in afterwards and bacteria continue to grow and adhere to each other. Bacteria along with their metabolites, cellular debris and salivary proteins accumulate and together form the plaque mass which continues to grow and mature. Now, there were two schools of thought with regards to plaque and its influence on dental caries. One was the non-specific plaque hypothesis and the other specific plaque hypothesis. Non-specific plaque hypothesis stated that the entire microflora in the plaque were collectively pathogenic and were responsible for the disease. Specific plaque hypothesis, on the other hand, stated that only particular bacterial species in plaque were pathogenic. However, Marsh had proposed another theory called the ecological plaque hypothesis, where he considered disease to result due to an ecological imbalance in the plaque microfloral community. Now, once plaque is formed, the bacterial composition of the plaque is diverse and varies at different sites. There is a microbial homeostasis or balance maintained between the different species of the microbial community in the plaque, in spite of subtle changes in different environmental factors like salivary flow, diet, or the host defense mechanisms. Now, it should also be noted that plaque could also harbor pathogenic disease-causing bacteria, but they are present in very small proportions and are not enough to cause the disease. However, a major environmental change or an ecological shift could lead to an imbalance in the bacterial community, favoring excess growth and survival of pathogenic species, leading to diseases like dental caries. So, as far as caries is concerned, a major shift in homeostasis could occur as a result of excess intake of sugar in the form of fermentable carbohydrates, especially sucrose. Streptococcus mutans and lactobacilli species have been implicated in causing dental caries. Streptococcus mutans metabolizes most of sucrose to meet its energy demands and produces lactic acid. Now, some of the sucrose is also used to form extracellular polysaccharides like glucans and fructans. Streptococcus mutans possesses an enzyme called invertase, which can cleave sucrose to glucose and fructose. And using another set of enzymes called glucosyl transferase and fructosyl transferase, Streptococcus mutans further converts glucose and fructose to extracellular polysaccharides called glucans and fructans respectively. Fructans are easily soluble and are used as a reservoir for further energy needs. However, glucans are insoluble and help in further adherence and accumulation of more caries-causing streptococci. Mutans contains glucans-binding proteins which help in its adhesion. So, this increase in lactic acid could decrease the pH of the local environment, making it very acidic. Caries-causing bacteria like Streptococcus mutans and Lactobacilli species can thrive and proliferate in such environments and start to increase in population. Besides thriving, they also produce more acid, and this ecological shift to an acidic environment increases cariogenic bacterial population and decreases the non-cariogenic bacterial population, altering the balance or homeostasis of the bacterial community. Now, an increase in acidic environment locally is usually buffered and neutralized within 30 to 60 minutes by calcium and phosphate ions in the saliva. The problem arises when the pH drops to 5.5 or below 5.5. In order to buffer the acidic environment, minerals from the saliva keep moving to the tooth-plaque interface. However, saliva starts to get undersaturated with minerals. And to meet the mineral demand in the saliva, hydroxyapatite crystals from the tooth start to disintegrate and move to the saliva. On removal of the acidic environment, the saliva, now supersaturated with minerals, precipitates minerals back to the tooth, remineralizing it. However, if the acidic environment is going to persist, hydroxyapatite crystals would continue to disintegrate, finally forming dental caries and cavitation on the tooth surface. Thank you.